Praise Lord. Greetings to you all in the matchless name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. It's such a joy to be able to stand here and speak from the Word of God after such a long time. When I was thinking of a topic to present, WWJD is what came on my mind. Kids, I'm sure you've heard this either during VBS or youth camps. I would like to share this as a reminder. Can someone tell me the full form of WWJD? That's right. What would Jesus do? In any situation of life that you're in, have you wondered what would Jesus do if he was in your place? So most people in this world learn about the views and lifestyles of celebrities that they like. They want to know about them and be like them, right? Consciously or unconsciously, they imitate whom they like. So these days, what are you following? You're following TikTok, Insta Reels, right? Who is your favorite celebrity? Whom do you like? Are you trying to be like them? But as a Christian, whom should you actually follow? Jesus, that's right. A Christian is widely concerned about following Jesus and seeks to walk in his steps and do his will. To this extent, there is value in asking, what would Jesus do? So what is your perspective? Are you interested in following whom the world admires? Or are you determined to follow the Lord Savior who loves you and wants to be with you forever? It is one or the other. You can't have it both ways. So what is your purpose? When we turn to the scriptures, 1 Peter 2 verse 21 says, Christ also suffered for you, leaving you an example to follow in his steps. And 1 John 2 verse 6 says, the one who says he abides in him ought to walk in the same manner as he did. So let's look at what Jesus did while he lived on this earth. Firstly, Jesus lived to please God. He was able to say, I always do the things that pleases my Father. Even God acknowledged, this is my beloved Son, in whom I am well pleased. We should learn what is pleasing to God. We must determine to please God in all that we think, we say, and do. We must be willing to say no to ourselves and yes to God in all things. Secondly, Jesus lived to obey God. Even Jesus knew he cannot please God unless he obeyed him. He said, I've come down from heaven not to do my own will, but the will of my Father who sent me. Are you and I sincerely committed to living in total obedience to the will of God? We know that only someone who does the will of God can enter the kingdom of God. Third, Jesus lived to do the work of God. Throughout his life, Jesus made the work of God his priority. Paul emphasizes, be steadfast, always abounding in the work of God. Are we consumed with the earthly affairs of life and distractions of this world that we lose sight of the work of God? Why are we here? Why are we in this world? We have to serve God, bless the lives of others, and bring them to God. That is the purpose. Fourth, Jesus lived with the knowledge that he would go to be with God. Do we set our minds on earthly things? Do we love the world or do we love God? Those who follow Jesus will have the same perspective of seeking things above. Let us be prepared for the second coming of Christ and let our focus be eternity. Finally, Jesus lived for the glory of God. The Bible says, whatever we do, whether we eat or drink, let's do it all for the glory of God. I would like to conclude my speech by saying, in the midst of any trials, temptations, or confusion, ask this question, what would Jesus do? Then you would know. So let's seek to know the mind of the Lord, walk as he walked, and do his will. May God bless you with those words. Thank you.
Thank you, sister. നല്ല മെസ്സേജിനായിട്ട് ദൈവത്തെ സ്തുതിക്കുന്നു. ചെറിയ മെസ്സേജ് ആയിരുന്നെങ്കിലും നമ്മൾ മനസ്സിലാക്കേണ്ട കാര്യം പറഞ്ഞത് എന്താണെന്ന് ചോദിച്ചു കഴിഞ്ഞാൽ, നമ്മൾ അഭിമുഖീകരിക്കുന്ന ഓരോ സാഹചര്യത്തിലും ആ സ്ഥാനത്ത് കർത്താവായ യേശു ക്രിസ്തു ആണെങ്കിൽ താൻ എന്തായിരിക്കും ചെയ്യുന്നത്, അത് നമ്മൾ കമ്പയർ ചെയ്ത് കഴിഞ്ഞാൽ നമ്മുടെ ജീവിതം ധന്യമായി തീരുവാൻ ഇടയായിത്തീരും എന്നാണ് പ്രസംഗത്തിലൂടെ നമ്മളെ അറിയിച്ചത്. കർത്താവ് സഹായിക്കട്ടെ. തിരുവനടിയായിത്തീരും എന്നാണ് പ്രസംഗത്തിലൂടെ നമ്മളെ അറിയിച്ചത്. കർത്താവ് സഹായിക്കട്ടെ. അടുത്ത